Hi, this is Miss Litton. This is wonderful lunchtime Friday afternoon review. Say hi.
Hi.
As you eat your lunch. Okay. So here are the big ticket items that you're going to need to know. Okay. Big ticket item number one. Whoa, go to that. Oh, hi. Big ticket item number one is making sure that you know your cell cycle. Okay. So if you remember this whole section here is interphase, and then remember that there were three parts to interphase, and in your mind you should be able to differentiate what happens in each part. Okay, so G1, don't even look at the board, it says something up there. G1, when it says growth, what does it mean? The cell gets bigger and you make more organelles. Good. S stands for what? What word?
Synthesis.
And what are you synthesizing during the S stage?
DNA.
Good. G2, what are you making more of? Proteins. Good. And then the M stage consists of two parts. What are the two parts it consists of? They're eating their lunch, so it's hard. Mitosis and cytokinesis. Okay. And when you go through the cell cycle, occasionally you might have, right, that G0 stage coming off of G1, which means I'm not going to go through any more divisions. I've stopped as a cell. We talked here, we did, what would come first? I've just listed all of them. You could start anywhere, but in our cell cycle, we're at the beginning, we just finished mitosis, what would be first? G1, and what should we see in G1? Cell get bigger and more organelles. What comes after G1? S, what should happen in the S stage? Making more DNA, good. Would it appear, would your chromosomes appear like that during the S stage? No, what would the chromosomes look like during the S stage? Something like that would came out of your hairbrush, right? It would be all globbed together. They would not have formed, guys, they would not have formed those chromosome structures yet, okay? Because chromosomes don't become visible until what stage? When do chromosomes become visible? What? Prophase, good. Girls, we're doing a review, so not this, okay? All right, and then what follows the S stage? G2, what happens during G2? Proteins. What's wrong with this picture besides you wouldn't see the chromosomes as visible? What else is wrong with this picture? The proteins are too big, right? Proteins would be much smaller. Okay, following G2, what would we undergo? What follows G2? Mitosis and cytokinesis. Okay, mitosis and cytokinesis. All right. When you have sister chromatids stuck together, do you count that as two chromosomes? No, that's one chromosome as long as they're stuck together. They don't graduate to their own chromosome structure until you have separated them during what? Anaphase. Okay? Now, when we talked about the cell cycle, the other thing you need to know is that there are controls that make it go either start or stop, okay, on that cell cycle. So those could be hormones, it could be an internal or external signal. We talked about it, we made an analogy with the airport, that to go forward in the cell, just like in the airport, you have to have two things in order to get on the plane. You have to have a ticket, and those are like the cyclins, and then you have to clear what? You have to clear security, and those are like those checkpoints. So it's a combination of having the ticket that says, yes, go through in mitosis, but here there's a checkpoint in the middle of it to make sure mitosis has gone well. Here, after you're done with mitosis, in the G1 stage, you're going to stop again and make sure that the chromosomes are separated appropriately and that your cell is functioning okay, and if not, you're either going to try to fix it or you're going to try to kill it. Before you move into the interphase stage, you have to have the right cyclins there that give you the green light to move into that stage. You'll have a checkpoint following that in G2 to make sure that the DNA was replicated appropriately. Okay, and then a normal thing that would happen if you could not correct it is a what? Apoptosis. Okay, so let's do this check first. And I have a bunch for you at the end as well. Why don't you be your favorite cereal?
belonged to me once. He still belongs to me. Next year. You miss me?
I like the blue.
Buckwheat hemp?
That's a cereal?
Please.
I'm going to pause this just for a minute while you're working on these. Okay, let's go ahead and check. See how you did? Yay. Anybody want to pick a different answer than that? Okay, let's talk about this one. During what stage are more organelles formed? That's always going to be during G1. Somebody picked G2. What happens during G2? More what? Protein. Good. Oh, dang it. Sorry. Okay, during what stage is there nuclear division? Division of the nucleus is called mitosis. Division of the cytoplasm and everything else is called what?
Cytokinesis.
Good. Okay, yay, good for you. All right, now, when we build a chromosome, remember we wind on those protein spools. You're going to want to know the name of those protein spools are called nucleosomes. Okay, so remember that part. Okay, and when does this winding up take place? When? Chromosomes become visible. When does the winding up take place? Prophase or prophase one? If we want to talk about mitosis and meiosis, all right? Haploid and diploid. Now that you've learned meiosis, probably the haploid and diploid number makes more sense to you. But remember, the haploid number is going to be found in the gametes or the sex cells, and the rest of your body cells are called somatic cells, and that those would be all diploid numbers. The process to go from 2N down to N. Okay, so N represents the haploid number. 2N is diploid because I have a set from one parent and a set from another parent. Yes? Okay. This process that does that is what? What is that called? So quiet today. What is that called?
Meiosis.
Meiosis. Good job. Okay, mitosis, I just want to tell you right now because we haven't learned about it because we haven't talked about fungi and other things like that. But you can go, in mitosis, you can go to 2N to 2N, but you can also go from, what else do you think?
End to
end. That's still going to be mitosis. If you're keeping the chromosome number exactly the same and you're making clones, that's mitosis. Okay, clarifying questions on that? Okay. Then basically, we talked about how plant cells have stem cells that can keep growing, but eventually we lose those parts that continue to grow. And then we went through the stages of mitosis. And I put the song up, okay? So it's on YouTube and Instagram, but let's do it together. Here we go. First of all, how many chromosomes are in this cell?
Two, okay?
So when I'm done with mitosis, how many chromosomes should be in each cell?
Two.
If I'm doing mitosis, I'm keeping it exactly the same, right? So in mitosis, during the S stage of interphase, this would have happened already. So when they do become visible, they always become visible like this, not like this, right? Okay? So the first stage is the prophase, and the chromosomes become visible. The nuclear envelope and the nucleolus disappear, radiating microtubules, asters. They meet in the middle at metaphase. Single file, because I'm talking about mitosis, right? Away at anaphase, to nuclei at telophase, cytokinesis. Perfect, okay? So this is showing you prophase, showing all of that occurring. And then here we go, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Okay, now, cytokinesis is different whether or not you're a plant or a what? Animal. Because animals, they can have a what furrow? Cleavage furrow. Whereas plants have to build a cell wall. Exactly. Okay, so here we can see that. All right, here we go. A few questions. Afterwards, you can log in and take these questions too. Good review for you. pause this real quick. Okay, just for the sake of time, I'm going to go ahead and keep going. Let's check it. Yay. I got it this way. Name the state. Chromosomes are in the middle as metaphase. Proteins are being synthesized. A lot of you got that G2. Some of you picked C, G1. What's getting made during G1? Organelles, and the cell is growing. One of you said S stage of interphase. No. What's getting made during the S stage of interphase? DNA. Sister chromatids are separating away at anaphase. No to you. Good, everybody got this? Division of the cytoplasm, cytokinesis. Nuclear membrane breaks down is prophase. Breaks down. And organelles are formed, G1. DNA replicated, S. Good job. Good. All right. We then said bacteria are a little bit different. Guys, it's getting loud out there. Bacteria are a little bit different. They do not have linear chromosomes like we do. They have single circular chromosomes. So they undergo binary fission. Okay, good job. Now, when you make a baby, okay, don't do that now. You take a sperm and an egg. Sperm and egg are haploid. Put them together and you have a diploid zygote. Now you know more, right? And you know everything that happens. We know a whole new dance for that. In the process of making your haploid cells, okay, we have to do meiomimeiosis, and that happens in your gonads. And in that, we brought up homologous pairs of chromosomes. Remember, they are the same size, same shape, and code for the same characteristics. When I talk about having a pair, one half of this pair came from my mom, the other half of this pair came from my dad, okay? So my mom gave me a chromosome 1, my dad gave me a chromosome 1. My mom gave me a chromosome 8, my dad gave me a chromosome 8. Those two 8s are a pair. Guys, it's distracting. Those two 8s are a pair. Each member of that pair during the S stage of interphase is going to replicate itself. So now I have 2 8s from mom and 2 8s from dad, but they're stuck together because they're called what? Sister chromatids. During meiosis 1, my job is get the pairs together, make sure that I've got all my pairs lined up in the middle, and then separate the pairs from each other. That's the divorce. The purpose of meiosis 2 is to separate the what? Sister chromatids. Okay? Homologous pairs, sister chromatids. If I'm going to have any chance of increasing variation, which gives natural selection something to work on, right? Variation in the process of doing meiosis happens in two places in the process of doing meiosis. Where are the two areas, two points where variation can take place? Independent assortment in metaphase 1, right? Because that's when I have my homologous pair. So they can line up any which way they want. Okay, where's the second point of variation? Crossing over, when does that occur? Prophase 1, okay? So prophase 1, when they synapses together, okay? That's when they can cross over. Then, relative to other chromosomes, we can have variety in metaphase 1, okay? The third point of variety has to do with after meiosis is done, and that's when what? You can tell me that one. Yeah, fertilization. It could be any sperm hooking up with any egg, right? So I don't know which sperm or which egg it's going to hook up with. So these were homologous pairs. I just want to make sure I kept recording. These are homologous pairs, then they replicated. These are sister chromatids. I separate the homologous pairs during meiosis 1 and sister chromatids during meiosis 2. So homologous pairs. Oh, and then here you get two of this and two of this. These could do crossing over, though, to increase variety during prophase 1. Separate in anaphase. All right, so we looked at the divisions. Okay, meiosis one, meiosis two takes place in two cells. You can look at those individual pictures and what you put in your notes. When they fail to separate, what's the word for when they fail to separate? Starts with an N. Non-disjunction. Good. So we know why those puppies are different. And spermatogenesis and oogenesis are different because every time males do meiosis, they make four sperm each meiotic event. But when females do meiosis, we only make one large egg and then what? Polar bodies, three little polar bodies. Okay? All right, here you go. Read the questions carefully because you can see there's little slight differences. And pause. Okay, let's check. You ready? Oh, Trixie. When do sister chromatids separate? Now let me just give you a little tip, okay, on this. When you see the word separate, what word should come to mind? Anaphase. So no matter what, it's gonna be an anaphase. So when you're choosing, it should either be anaphase one or anaphase two. Those are your only choices, okay? Anaphase one and anaphase two are E and F. So I don't know where these A, Bs, and Cs are coming from, but they're coming from a state of confusion, okay? If something's separating, it's got to be an anaphase. Now, what are the only options on separation? Either what? Homologous pairs or sister chromatids. Okay? So if I'm at sister chromatids, remember the divorce happens first and then you rip the sisters apart. So it's got to be anaphase two. Okay? If I was talking about mitosis, what stage would I say? Anaphase. There is no one or two. Okay? All right, let's check your next one. Okay, name the stage of meiosis where nuclear membrane rebuilds for the first time two cells total. Okay, if I'm rebuilding a membrane, it's either a telophase one or it's a what? Telophase two. And I'm telling you it rebuilt for the first time, so it's gotta be a telophase one, plus it's telling me there's only a total of how many cells? Two. That's my hint for that. Where you came up with metaphase, not at all. Point of confusion. Okay, where does crossing over occur? There's only one option for crossing over. One stage only. It doesn't ever happen in mitosis. It only happens in meiosis, and it's always prophase one. Prophase, the chromosomes become visible in prophase one, and you still have nuclear and this, all of this, but they do synapses right away in prophase one. They become one thing in prophase one, that tetrad, okay, that bivalent where crossing over can occur, okay? Not in metaphase at all. Crossing over doesn't happen then. In metaphase, what are we looking at? Independent assortment. You can see evidence of crossing over in metaphase two, but it's not actually crossing over. Yay, did a good job, four haploid cells. Single chromosomes are formed, nuclear envelope may be breaking down again. If I say the word again, then it's already done it before, so it's got to be prophase two. Most of you got that. Homologous pairs are separating. If it's a separation, it has to be an anaphase, and if homologous pairs are there, it's got to be anaphase one. Okay, somebody put prophase one. Is there anything to do with separation and prophase? No. Homologous pairs are in the middle. When you see the word middle, what stage do we have to be talking about if the word middle is there? It's got to be a metaphase. And if you're with your homologous pair, okay, the parents are still together, that's got to be metaphase one. So first identify stage and then decide logically one or two. Single chromosomes are in the middle. Again, if the word is middle, it's got to be a metaphase. If it's single chromosomes, not homologous pairs, it's got to be metaphase two. And your book has stages in it, and that's the end. Questions anybody wants to ask me? Okay, Smarty McSmarties, have good weekends and all of that. This quiz isn't until later, but this
was the review I wanted to get done for today, so you had it before you went away for the weekend. All right.
Have good evenings. If you're watching this before the quiz and it's late, you can have a piece of toast. Make good choices.